Okay, Joe, we've looked at your car, dude. It's not a happy situation, is it?
No, it's not.
Well, you got one good thing on you, bud. Guess what?
I got Pete on my side. No.
Well, that's true, too. But the problem is you don't have a lot of rust on your car. I'm pretty surprised. I'm amazed. You know what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
So, that's really saved your ass on restoring your car over at my friend Pete's. Plus, my friend Pete likes to work with people. Found out that Joe can't afford the pristine job, but my friend Pete always does a pristine job.
That's true.
Am I right?
That's right.
Joe's a working man like Pete. Joe's a working man like Bruno. Am I right, Joe?
Oh, he is.
Or did you just come in there dressed like that just to fool me?
No. No, I didn't come in for you.
So we got the 1974 Karma Ghia, and we're gonna flip the dice, bud. We might work on it. Wait, do you still gotta think about it, Joe? Or no, sir? Now, this is the situation we have. Joe is a working guy. Joe works for a living, but he's had his car for 20 years. Now, what the situation is, Joe, we're going to have to go on, not really the payment plan, but stage plan. So we're going to be doing his car in stages, because that sometimes that's how you got to do it if you want it done right. No, Joe is not going to give me half the money up front and half when it's done. I don't work that way. I only collect money when I need the money, when I'm working on your car. Because when I do that, bud, that's not helping me out, it's also helping you out. Am I right? So, in turn, we're helping each other out, bud, and that's how it should be. Because I want to make sure that this is a nice job for Joe. Am I right, Joe?
Yes, sir. You're right.
So, we didn't find a lot of rust on Joe's car, and we didn't, find a lot of bad damage, and it looks like the floors are salvageable, bud. I think Scrappy Charlie can get in there and do some scraping, and the floors will look pretty nice.
Sounds good.
Okay. Are you happy at all, Joe? I mean,
oh, I feel better now. After
talking about what?
After we talked.
About what?
About where we stand and what we're looking at. Yeah, I feel a lot better. Putting it out there in front and working with people. I feel a lot better.
Well, you know, that's how life should be, bud. Everybody should work with everybody. You know what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
But that's how life is. Matter of fact, you came a long way out of your way just so my friend Pete can look at your car.
Yes.
You didn't have to do all that. You could have sent me detailed pictures of it on eBay. But instead, you brought it all the way up here. Now, I gave you a prize, right? Now, I'm going to ask you again. I'm going to explain it to you, bud. Don't feel bad if you want to take your car with you. Don't feel upset if you want to leave your car here and you want to start on it in a month or two from now. Okay? That's all up to you. Alright? I'm not going to twist your arm to work on your car. I'm not going to put a shotgun to your head and say you're leaving your car with me. It's your car, bud. You can do whatever you want with your car. Okay. I appreciate you bringing your car all the way up here for me to look at. That's an honor. That's a long way to go. So you must really like my videos to do all that, bud. Now, do you want to think about it for a few minutes, or what do you think you ought to do, Joe?
I was hoping I could leave it here and start working on it in August.
You want to leave it here and start working on it in a couple months? Okay, Joe, I'll tell you what we're going to do, bud. Why don't we go ahead? Are you sure you feel comfortable leaving your car at my shop?
Yes, sir.
Because you don't seem like you do, bud.
No, I trust you in every way.
It's not like I'm going to take your car and leave.
No, sir.
What do you think, Bob?
I think that's a good idea to leave it here.
As a lot of work pulling it up here, but you know, you can pull it back just the same. Be done with it by tonight. Okay, what we're gonna do, we're gonna go ahead and find a nice cozy spot in the back. We'll unload it over there. If that's what you want to do.
Yes.
Okay, we won't start working on it for a couple months. That's the agreement. That's fine with me. I don't have time to work on it right now anyway. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
And you need to go purchase a tarp and some tie downs, bud. Do you know what tie downs are? Those rubber tie downs? Because when we put all this in your car here, put it all together, I want to be able to make sure that that tarp stays on there very tight. I don't want the wind to blow the tarp off. I don't want to have to go out there and babysit your fucking car, bud. If I'm going to keep it back there for you for a couple months, I want to make sure the fucking thing's secure. I don't want to have to fucking watch it every day. Is that understood, Bob?
Robert?
Yeah. Bob for short, right? Bobby, Bob? What do you think?
That sounds good.
I'm talking a little anger here, bud, because I'm just telling you, I want to make it square to you.
Okay.
The fucking thing's got, at least got to be covered, dude.
Yes.
Okay, Joe?
Got it.
What do you want to do, Joe? Yeah. Tell me.
I want Pete to work on my car, and that's pretty much all I want.
Okay. Appreciate you coming in, Joe. Take care. Robert, keep up that shotgun. Are you in a club?
I'm 4-H.
I know, but what is it, like a shotgun club? Or?
Yeah.
Is it a skeeter, skeet type shooting?
Skeet, traps, sporting clays, 5-stand.
Wow. So you have some real fancy shotguns in.
Riding Satori.
Okay, slow down, bud. Tell everybody what you got here, because there's probably other guys out there that are shooters.
Shoot a Browning Satori. Six.
You're gonna have to talk loud, but the microphone can't pick you up.
625 Satori Browning. And I have a Beretta automatic, but I don't ever use that one.
That's a 12 gauge.
Yeah, they're both 12.
So when you're talking shotgun, everything you shoot is 12 gauge, right? Are you shooting slugs or are you shooting birdshot? Okay, guys, I guess we've wasted enough bullshit time on the camera. You think it's time to load her up, Joe?
Oh, yes.
Are you sure about this, Joe? Don't be nervous, bud. Don't be shy. You don't feel comfortable, and your gut feeling's telling you I shouldn't do this, but I'm gonna. What do you think, bud?
I'm sure.
Sure. I don't want your car, okay? I'm gonna tell you right now, I don't want to keep your car. I don't want your car. Do you understand? I don't want you to drop your car off here and then forget about your car. I don't need another junker. Dude, did you see my backyard, Joe?
Yes.
Okay, I got junkers sitting there already. I don't need another junker to haul off. Okay?
All right.
That means if you're going to do this, you have to stick to your guns and get her done, bud.
Okay.
You have to have a positive attitude about it and say, I will do this. You've had the car for 20 years, bud. Am I right?
That's right.
Okay. What's making you get off your ass now and do this thing? What the hell, bud? What's going on there? What's up with that angle?
I guess I was tired of seeing it just sitting there.
What were you doing? Watching videos on YouTube or something and said, man, I wish mine looked like that. Oh my gosh, I like that one. E.G. Wow, look at this.
Yeah, pretty much.
And then what? You came across Pete's and what happened? What do you want to do, Joe? Let's hear the answer now. Let's just get it out. What the fuck does Joe want to do with the Karmann fucking Ghia?
Have Pete fix it.
Okay. Let's get the bastard unloaded. Let's get Charlie to help you unload it. It's almost fucking lunchtime for me, Joe. You want to go eat a burger with us? That's fine. You can go with us on your way out of fucking town. Okay, we'll split our ways difference that way. What do you think of that, bud? It's going to take probably 30 fucking minutes to get that car unloaded. I'm going to get Charlie out there to help you. Okay?
Sounds good.
Well, Manny, Joe's made his mind up. We're gonna keep the car here and we're gonna work on it later.
So you tied his hand behind his back and forced
him? No, actually Robert put the shotgun on his shoulder. You ready to go, Joe?
I'm ready.
You're gonna get her done?
Get her done.
So what's the situation? You saw Pete's videos and you said, man, this guy's crazy.
Yeah, that was part of it.
You said, I gotta watch another one.
Yeah, and then...
And then after that, you saw this car movie and you said, man, that dude has inspired me to fucking get it done.
That's
Thank
right.
you, I appreciate that. Are you telling me I helped you out, Joe? My friend Pete helped you out. Good. Hey, Charlie! Oops! shit! You okay, Joe? What the fuck, bud? Are you alright?
Yeah.
Okay, come on, bud. They're gonna pull this car around the back here.
Okay.
You okay, Joe?
I'm alright.
What happened, dude? You hit the curb of my door there, bud.
Yeah.
Be careful, dude.
Hit the curb of my truck,
too. Alright, come on over here. We're gonna show you where to unload your car, okay?
Alright.
Actually, it's actually a pretty clean car, McGee. Don't. So where do you think I want you to put your car, bud?
Right next to
the other fucking guy. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Let's get it in there nice and neat. Look, you can see that I've already got a car out of there. There used to be a car there, but I fixed it for the guy and it's gone. Put it right next to that spot there where it's, you see where there's no grass growing. Get yourself a couple rocks out here. I'm sure Charlie can find some boulders or something. Okay, block the tires. Put all your parts inside the car. And guess I think I got a tarp we can use. I don't know. I don't think I have the tie downs, but we're gonna have to get those.
Sounds good.
But the problem we got, Joe, is if I use my tarp, then I don't fucking have a tarp.
I'm gonna go get a tarp.
Okay, let's go. All right, Charlie, and then we're gonna unload the car. We're gonna put it over here in the back and work on it later. This is Pete, and you see Tony? He's a happy guy now, right, Tony? Okay, we'll see y'all later. Take it easy. All right, you know. My name's Pete, and this is Bruno, and we're over at SouthwestRodCustom.com.